finally, we're getting tidbits of information. We getting some of them clues and some of them hints about the future of the Power Rangers franchise. Yesterday, Hasbro had a very important investors call. And a copy of the investors call is on YouTube. So your boy had to listen in. They had some interesting things to say about the future of G.I. Joe. Don't care. The future of My Little Pony. Really don't care. But then at the end of the call, they talked about Power Rangers, mentioning the streaming future of the show, the new TV series, and also a little bit of information about the movie. Yo, we got something cool to talk about. Meaning, we got the Marcus Digital Special, where I talk in a circle for 10 minutes. No cap. That's my favorite. How you foreign niggas stop it? I was born in the tropics. I'm the way peep the mosh pit. And it came with a starship. Yeah, I got it. Yeah, I'm really from the tropics. Fuck is you doing? What's good, Digital Trap Squad? Y'all know what it is, so check it, right? Alright, y'all. So we all know Power Rangers, the franchise, has been around since 1993 over here in North America. It's been around for a long time. And myself, along with some other people in the Power Rangers community, have kind of grown stale of the show, of the brand, and what it's currently doing. The landscape around the superhero medium has significantly changed since the days of Dino Thunder. Hell, since the days of RPM, it has significantly evolved. And we want Power Rangers as a brand to kind of catch up to where everybody else is. And within this investor call, there were a lot of comparisons when they were speaking, talking about Marvel, talking about WandaVision and the success of that show, mentioning the money that the second quarter of Disney Plus made from The Falcon and the Winter Soldier. Meaning that Hasbro is looking at the MCU saying, we want that. We really want that. And I don't blame them. Shit, they print money over there. Who wouldn't want to be a part of that? Who wouldn't want to mirror that? And within this call, they had a lot of interesting things to say. Now, before we get into the call, I want you to say, thank you, Marcus, because this call is an hour long. These people are boring as hell to listen to. I didn't even have my goddamn dinner yet, and they put me to sleep three times, okay? It's some boring shit, but we're going to play the Power Rangers portion of the investor call. Here you go.
Our film coming next year in partnership with Paramount, and then Power Rangers, you'll hear more about it, but we've been developing that, and we expect shortly to be able to talk about the brand, new content for the brand that will go after a multitude of audiences that will be on a streaming platform. So a very good position for the company, and we look at all of our opportunities. But you're right, we've entered an era where there's unprecedented spending on content and an unprecedented desire for great brands with great story. And E1 is expert at that.
Now, within that clip, you heard them speak about the movie with Paramount that we all know is in development. Apparently, it's going to be about time travel involving a Ranger team today going back to the 90s. I don't know how I feel about that. I don't know how I feel about that. But they also talked about having a diverse audience for a TV series that's going to be on a potential streaming platform, already established or a new one. And there are so many ways you could go with a Power Rangers streaming show in the future, especially considering that they said they want a diverse audience for this show, meaning we're no longer going to be having Gerber food, meaning we can put the kid cuisines away. We're going to be having something that reflects the modern superhero era. Thank fucking God. And I got one thing to say. Fuck them.
You thought I was gonna say it. You thought I was gonna say fuck them kids, but I'm not gonna say that because there are people that watch this channel that are following me all over the internet. Wherever I post, Instagram or Twitter, and their replies are, "Hey Marcus, fuck them kids." There's been a lot of shit going on YouTube over the past, I don't know, 2 weeks involving kids.
Well, I was actually coming out here to pick up a cupcake and then go back home.
Kill him. Kill him now.
So, yeah, that joke has to officially be retired. And we're going to get a nice little Celine Dion song. We're going to meditate. We're going to focus. And we're going to reflect. The fuck them kids joke had a good run. It was a really good run. I got a lot of good memes out of it. I made people laugh. I made people adore Marcus Digital with the fuck them kids jokes. But it's time to evolve. I want to use my platform for the right things. I want to get the sexiest woman possible. I'm still waiting for Tiana Trump to reply to my DM that I sent her in 2018. I know she's busy, but she hasn't replied to me yet. It's heartbreaking. I have to evolve, you guys, and the fuck them kids joke gotta go. Now, y'all making me sound like Princess Shayla from Wild Force when she had to sing to the Deer Zord. That shit was cringe as hell. But getting back to the future of Power Rangers, there's a lot of interesting ways you can go when you think about the future and where we might end up. We know that last year we got a rumor from out of nowhere. The Illuminati nerdy James Gunn shitted all over them a few months ago, talking about Saban / Hasbro. Really, Hasbro is no longer going to be working with Toei Animation. Toei Animation, we know, is the company that's ahead of Super Sentai. They're no longer going to be working with them. So future Power Ranger movies or adaptations won't be taking inspiration from the Sentai. And I can't be the only person that heard that and said, hell, we lit. We lit. I know a lot of people don't like the concept of Power Rangers deviating away from Sentai. No, you need to adapt to Sentai. They know what they're doing over there. Their stories are all great. Bruh, if you're going to keep this thing a buck, keep this thing trill all the way through, keep it 100, keep it 100. I'm busting out all the Saiyans. No cap. Some of the best stories in Power Rangers, some of the best stories have been when they've deviated away from Sentai. Lost Galaxy was an American story. It was 100% an American story. And that's one of the few original Saban era seasons that gets better with age, right? A story about sacrifice. Shout out to the Disney brain. Great fucking title on the video, but a story about sacrifice. So many sacrifices made in Lost Galaxy. It gets better with age. Y'all know where I'm going? Y'all know where I'm going? Room, room. I don't know why I did that, but I just did that. Power Rangers RPM is an American story. Power Rangers RPM, Go Ranger, was totally different in Japan. Totally different. I watched 2 episodes and said, I'm good. I'm good forever. I'm decent. I'm all right. Some of the best stories have been when they've been inspired by their own storylines that they've established previously. Once a Ranger from Operation Overdrive being an amazing 2-episode arc. That shit was amazing. So much potential with the Power Rangers franchise. and where they could go in the future. Now, when they talked about a diverse audience, we know that that means everybody, right? It doesn't just mean adults or edgy teens. It means everybody. So if you're somebody coming to this video wanting Power Rangers in the future to be blood and gore, wanting decapitations, all right, wanting the Pink Ranger to bust up a sex trafficking ring, you're going to be disappointed, okay? Because it's still Power Rangers. It still has a certain type of brand, a certain type of energy to maintain overall. But can it reflect the Marvel Cinematic Universe? A tone that's right for everybody? Yes, it can. Yes, it can. And hopefully, that's more of the inspiration Hasbro and E1 is going to take for the future of the franchise. A very interesting investor call. I personally would not suggest that you listen to it, because the Power Rangers part is at the very end and it'll probably put you into a coma. It's that goddamn boring. Anyway, it's been weird, but it's been real. Yo, I want my 2 hours back listening to that bullshit. Had to keep on rewinding it. Oh, fuck, man. That shit was boring. Alright, get out of here, bitch. When I pull up, she gon' look though. Look at he mad, ain't look, bro. She bad as hell, but can't cook though. It don't matter, but you still watching me while I did it for the look though. 100 feet worth of drip, don't drown this fly shit. That's the look though. And look though, I'm the wave, you can look though. I'm something different, I don't think you get it, but I still did it for the look though. Look though, look though, yeah, I did it for the look though.